You had to ask me what the two biggest problems with New York State's new proposed ban on non-competes. There are two issues that really stand out above all others, at least to me. Number one is that it is far from clear when the time within which to challenge a proposed non-compete agreement would really start to run. And to that end, the proposed law says the employee shall bring such action within 2 years of the later of one, when the prohibited non-compete agreement was signed, two, when the employee learns of the prohibited non-compete agreement, three, when the employment relationship is terminated, or four, when the employer takes any steps to enforce the non-compete agreement. Particularly when you took at items two and four of that language, an employee can say, well, I didn't know about it for years and years on end, which means it theoretically could go on indefinitely. And that alone clouds what timing you're looking at. So an employer might know when they're theoretically in the clear on this. Second, there is no express carve out, unlike even, let's say, for example, in California, where in connection with the sale of a business, where they say that if you're buying the goodwill of a business, that a non-compete under those circumstances would be permissible, because what, after all, is the buyer really trying to do? They're trying to buy the goodwill of the customer base of the business, and that's primarily what they're paying for. But in their haste to try and get a non-compete ban on the books, New York State's legislature did not include such language in this proposed law, and that is clearly a big oversight on their part. If you have any other questions about non-competes in general, or particularly this new proposed non-compete agreement, non-compete ban under New York law, please feel free to give me a call. My name is Jonathan Cooper, and my number is 516-791-5700. I hope you found this helpful. Have a great day.